So we talked about surgery in the setting of recurrence. Thank you, Shannon. We talked about all three PARP inhibitors and bevacizumab. We have now four targeted therapies FDA approved in recurrent ovarian cancer. And so, again, the era has arrived. As one final comment, I want each of you, as we go, and maybe you already said it, what is the combination, investigational combination strategy in recurrent ovarian cancer that you're most excited about? We don't need to get into all the detail, but what are you most excited about? Is it targeted combination in recurrent ovarian cancer? I'll let you go first.
Well, I mean, I think I already referenced that the PARPs and the antiangiogenics are very exciting. I think there are nice preclinical rationale about why they would each kind of amplify the response to each other, and potentially that we could be expanding who benefits from PARP, who truly benefits from PARP more.
Yeah. What do you think, Dave? What's your combination?
I think the most exciting combination, if I had to check just two right now, in recurrent, are PARP inhibitors with the checkpoint inhibitors. Hopefully with the PARP increasing neoantigens, the checkpoint inhibitors then maximizing.
The challenge has been is that the median PFS, which is the endpoints on these trials, is about the same, let's say in 214 versus 218. So the reason all these wonderful trials are being done frontline, because the developers say, well, if the endpoints happen at the same time, and there are more patients frontline, there always are, and if I can get more uptake and return on my investment, I'm preferentially going to do a frontline trial than a platinum sensitive trial. So you're right, but the development has shifted to frontline. What combination are you excited about?
So combination is actually the combination of an antibody drug conjugate called mirvetuximab plus pembrolizumab. This is a study that a number of us have been involved in, and there are true response rates here. So I think those types of IO plus unique other drug combinations, ADCs, this one happens to be mirvetuximab, are exciting for me.
Yeah, so I'm asked all the time, you know, where are we and where are we going? Yeah. So we were in an angiogenesis world. It will close ultimately, assuming 218 gets approved. And we live in a PARP space. We live in a PARP world, we have three approved. And we're developing IO, we've all talked about it. So what's next? ADC. Mm-hmm. And ADC is the next wave. And I'm excited about that. And the leading, obviously, this Forward One study, which is folate receptor antibody drug conjugate versus physician's choice chemotherapy, will close to enrollment in recurrent ovarian cancer very soon. Yeah, and I know you're very passionate about it. What combination are you interested in?
Well, I think, again, rarely do I agree with David O'Malley, but I would stick with probably David. But the big issue I have is I like all of them, and I'm going to find out what's the right patient and personalized medicine and agree with Shannon.
Thank
and
you.
I think the MIRVA data is, from what I see, is quite exciting. I mean, it's I know that doesn't add much to this discussion, but I'm so excited to be an oncologist at this point and have treatment options for my patients.
It's actually satisfying. Mm-hmm. To be a gynec to treat ovarian cancer patients. So this has been very informative. I want to thank the four of you for being with us today. On behalf of OncLive, thank you very much, and so long for now.